The topic is interesting. It's a relevance of Indian scriptures in the ever-changing world of media and entertainment. So I want to just begin by clarifying the role of mythology in the world of entertainment. So if you were to submit a script to Hollywood, 90% of the time, they will expect you to follow a particular structure of storytelling, which is called monomyth, which was created by Joseph Campbell in the 70s. And it is based on a Greek structure of storytelling. तो अगर स्टोरी बताना है तो वो एक पर्टिकुलर स्टाइल में ही बताना है एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड द ग्रीक स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्टोरी टेलिंग वेयर देयर इज यू इंट्रोड्यूस द कैरेक्टर देन यू क्रिएट अ क्राइसिस एंड देन यू रिजॉल्व द क्राइसिस इट इज द थ्री पार्ट स्टोरी टेलिंग स्ट्रक्चर एंड इट इज बेस्ड ऑन ग्रीक मिथोलॉजी सो एंड दिस इज समथिंग दैट मोस्ट पीपल struggle with because we assume this is the only way stories are told. Kahani ko batane ka alag alag tarika hota hai but we have now stuck to this hero mode and you see this hero mode in many modern writers where they are continuously asking for the transformation of the hero. The hero hota hai and the hero has to change over time. So when you, a classic example of the monomyth is the Star Wars trilogy. The Star Wars trilogy is the most classic story where there's a young boy who transforms into a Jedi Knight and whatever happens. Lord of the Rings. For the last 15 years, I have met at least 30 production houses who want to create Lord of the Rings. They will meet me and say, Devdutt ji, humko their Lord of the Rings banana hai. So I say, this is my fee. And they said, ye hum afford nahi kar payenge. I said, Lord of the Rings बना नहीं पाओगे क्योंकि पैसे हैं नहीं तुम्हारे पास सिर्फ ड्रीम्स हैं तुम्हारे पास पैसे नहीं है मतलब टाइम नहीं है यू डोंट हैव टाइम बिकॉज़ दीस थिंग्स टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू प्रोड्यूस द प्री प्रोडक्शन वर्क इज कॉम्प्लेक्स एंड डिटेल्ड द अमाउंट ऑफ वर्क दैट गोज इन टू क्रिएटिंग कैरेक्टर्स स्ट्रक्चर्स नैरेटिव्स इज सो डिटेल्ड दैट इट रिक्वायर्स मनी If you don't have that money, why dream? He said, no, but we should dream big. Dreaming big is good, but if you don't have the resources, then there is a problem. Because ultimately, storytelling is a business. Somebody is going to put in money and he wants something out of it. He wants return on investment. So when we're talking about storytelling and relevance of Indian myths in the ever-changing media, we have to look at storytelling from two points of view. The story itself and the business aspect of it. They're two different things. The story itself, where I said monomyth, the famous Greek structure of the monomyth. It is there all the time. Where there is a hero, And he has to become, of course, now it is superhero. Again, many production houses will call me for lectures and say, Devdutt, we want to create a superhero. India mein superhero kyun nahi banta hai? We have so many stories. We have Ramayana, Mahabharata, mythology. We have got magical things happening in our stories. But why don't we have a Superman? Why don't we have an Iron Man? Why don't we have Guardians of the Galaxy? Why don't we have Titans continuously, and I keep asking them when they say this, I say, but that is because we are Indian, and the idea of superhero doesn't fit well with Indian thought. Children may like superheroes as long as they are white guys. It's only in the recent time, one film, Black Panther, where a black superhero has appeared. But gora hona chahiye. Try to make a superhero with a Chinese character. Let's see how well it does. It doesn't gel because all stories exist in a cultural context. And that's what I want to talk to you about. कि व्हेन वी से इंडियन स्टोरी टेलिंग व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय इंडियन स्क्रिप्चर स्टोरी टेलिंग इज इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द वेस्टर्न स्टोरी टेलिंग इज इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट हॉलीवुड विल डिमांड ऑफ यू and how the difference creates issues in actual case studies. Because over the last 5 to 6 years I've worked with Star TV Network, I've worked with writers, I've worked with actors, production houses, and you suddenly realize the dissonance between the scriptures and the reality of production. Zameen Aasman ka fark hai. One wants TRP ratings. For example, I'll give a classic example. According to the scriptures, Krishna is black in color, ghanashyam, as black as the rain clouds. You must have heard these wonderful songs, Gulzar's first song, Mohe Shyam Rang De De, Mera Gora Ang Le Le. Or you must have heard the famous Yashomati Maya, Radha Kyu Gori, Main Kyu Kala. Now go to the television channels and show me one dark Krishna. They are fair, they are light-eyed, and they look like Farex babies. Mote, safed, golu, molu. So sweet, but Krishna ka rang nahi hai. He's not dark, he's fair. Why? Because the market wants fair Krishna. Bhagwan ke kala kaise ho sakte hai, yaar? Bhagwan kala nahi ho sakte. Bhagwan to safed hona chahiye. Arey, but Krishna, the word Krishna means black. The word Krishna means black. When you go to Jagannath temple, they use soot made of ghee, kajal ka jo material hai, to make him black. So the scriptures say Krishna is black, but the television insists Krishna should be white. This is the difference. Because one is demanded by the audience. Audience ratings will go down if Krishna is black. When you do Krishna Radha stories, and I will show you scriptures after scriptures after scriptures after scriptures, Krishna Radha relationship is anything but puritanical. It is anything but puritanical. It is deeply embedded in India's tantric culture. It talks about sex at a level which is very detailed. Not, and it is not Sanskrit narratives. Krishna Parampara does not come from Sanskrit. It comes from Maithili, Avadhi, Brajbhasha, Udiya, Bengali, Kannada, Telugu, Tamil, Malayalam. Deeply erotic narratives. Try to do this on television. You will have somebody saying, Ye Deshdrohi hai. Because how can Krishna and Radha have anything but brother-sisterly like love and affection? Cute romance hona chahiye. Nothing physical is allowed. So the problem is you cannot really tell stories without taking the audience into consideration. The audience in many ways is controlling your storytelling. It is telling you what it wants to see. Can I have the lights on? Don't make it dark. Whoever's handling the lights, just keep the lights on. It's fine. I'm not going to dance on stage. Yeah, we'll talk and then we'll have a question answer session. So what is the fundamental difference? Let's take the word superhero for example. Superhero. Why do Indian scriptures don't have superhero? Hanuman is not a superhero. He can fly like Superman, but he is not a superhero. Ram is not a superhero. Krishna is not a superhero. In Hollywood, they made a film called Avatar. Avatar is not Avatar. Avatar is an American imagination of what Avatar is. Because I had an opportunity to meet those guys, and they told me, isn't it Indian? I said, no, sir, it's a Greek story. You have told me a Greek story, it is nothing to do with India. Blue color and tail doesn't make him Hanuman or Vishnu. This is cosmetic. It is not systemic. It is not the soul. If you want to, for example, understand Chinese stories, I remember this wonderful film called Red Cliff. It is a $1 billion film when it was released in China, in Hong Kong, Taiwan. In Bombay, I went for the first show. Nobody in the theater, except one couple in the corner, which was having a very good time not looking at the screen. Which means the Indian audience was not getting the Chinese ethos, which is embedded in Red Cliff. And Red Cliff may not work in California. Yet, Hollywood stories succeed across the world. What are they doing right and what are we not doing right? The fundamental thing is the West understands itself better than we understand ourselves. Until you understand yourself, you don't know how to edit and change and make it global. Till you don't understand your ethos, you will never be able to talk the global language. And that is very critical. Let me begin with just one example. Superhero versus avatar. Farak kya hai? What is a superhero? A superhero is an ordinary man who becomes extraordinary. So Peter Parker becomes Spider-Man. Bruce Wayne becomes Batman. Clark Kent, who is ordinary in the planet Krypton, becomes extraordinary when he comes to Earth as Superman. So it is always an ordinary man who becomes extraordinary. He gets special powers. He gets special powers with which, now that is one part of the story. The second part, what do you do with the special powers? With these special powers, you solve problems. Usually it is the end of the world. The planet is coming to an end and the superhero will save the world from coming to an end. So it's problem solving. Two things. So ordinary man becomes extraordinary, and when he becomes extraordinary, he uses his extraordinary powers to solve a problem. This is the classical structure of a superhero film. Now let us understand what is the meaning of the word avatar. What does avatar mean? Avatar word comes from the Sanskrit phrase avatarana, which means to come down. Who is coming down? Vishnu is coming down. Narayan is coming down. From where? From Vaikunth. He is coming from up to down. What is up there? In Vaikunth, he is immortal. He is limitless. He has no boundaries. He is immortal, infinite, limitless. But he chooses to come down to the earth and he becomes mortal. He becomes finite. He becomes limited. Which means he is extraordinary. And he becomes ordinary, which is the opposite of a superhero. Superhero is an ordinary man who becomes extraordinary. Avatar is an extraordinary being who becomes ordinary. Ye do alag alag baatein hain. For the last 5 years, I have worked with writers who will listen to me and say, but sir, but sir, but sir, because they want Ram to be superhero. That is why all young boys who are drawing graphic novels will make Ram with a six-pack. Hanuman has a six-pack. The worst, Ganpati now has a six-pack. But on a concave stomach. I'm still trying to figure out how that happens. But it happens, because six-packs nahi hoega toh superhero nahi ban sakta na sir. That is why I look at the artist and say, bhaiya, tu मीडियोकर ही रहेगा। अच्छा करें, बिकॉज दे वांट मी टू मोटिवेट देम, दे डोंट वांट मी टू टेल द ट्रूथ। सो इट्स वेरी वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड। इफ आई टेल देम द ट्रूथ, इज सर आप डीमोटिवेट कर रहे हो सर। बट भैया ग्लोबल मार्केट में तेरा नहीं चलेगा, तेरे को खा जाएंगे दो मिनट में। They will eat you raw and throw you out because you are nothing compared to the best artists in the West. You are imitating them. You have nothing original to offer. I know which book you are copying from. मेरे को पता है तू DC पढ़ रहा है, महंगा पढ़ रहा है। तेरा उधर से ही आ रहा है idea, कुछ नया idea नहीं है। There's nothing Indian. नहीं सर, India में बिकता नहीं है। अरे market तो बना। But कैसे market बनेगा? You have not taken the time to study. और जब कोई सिखाना चाहता है तो बोलता है नो बट सर, नो बट सर। इन माय ओपिनियन राम इज एक्चुअली अ सुपर हीरो। नो ही इज नॉट, ट्रस्ट मी, थोड़ा पढ़ाऊ मैं। बट दिस एरोगेंस इज व्हाट स्टॉप्स अस फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग एंड बीइंग ब्रिलियंट एट आवर वर्क, बिकॉज इंडियंस हैव द पोटेंशियल टू बी ब्रिलियंट, बट वी आर टू बिजी कॉपिंग। We are trying very hard, we are not working on original, being true to ourselves. I spoke to a producer recently who has made serious hit shows. She is soap queen, she does all romance. And I spoke to her and I said, what is the one ingredient that works? She says, honesty. Jab main show banati hu, I believe in my characters. I genuinely believe in my characters. The girl is struggling to wear jeans in a middle class household in a small town. Main wo ladki hoon. But when they are writing Ramayana, nobody believes in Rama. If a woman is writing Ramayana, she thinks Ram is a male chauvinist pig. You really think it will succeed in the market? When you're writing the Mahabharat, they think it's a revenge drama. उतना ही पढ़ा है क्या महाभारत का? For 2000 years you think it's a revenge drama? 2000 years the story has been told again and again, and you think it's a revenge drama? And I'm trying to explain the structure, but you don't want to listen. We keep talking about innovation, but we don't want to learn. We don't believe India is brilliant. We just don't want to believe that we have fantastic ideas. Which means mining, polishing, and presentation to the world. For which we have to work hard at understanding our culture. Superhero is not avatar. When the avatar comes down from heaven, he is mortal. Now, this is the. Does he come down to solve the problem? Because superhero solves the problem. तो लोग हाँ सर कृष्ण बोला ना धर्म स्थापना युगे युगे, सो ही कम्स डाउन टू सॉल्व अ प्रॉब्लम। ऐसे कौन सा प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व किया, कौन सा प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व किया? तो कौरवों को मारा ना सर। ऐसे बट कौरव एंड्स अप इन हेवन नो, लास्ट में व्हेन यू रीड द मैं नहीं सर मैंने नहीं पढ़ा है। ऐसे तूने नहीं पढ़ा है तो सही चाहिए गलत है? यू हैव नॉट डन योर रिसर्च, you have not done your research, and you have not understood the meaning of the word dharma. You have assumed dharma means justice, but dharma doesn't mean justice. Uske liye alag shabd hai, nyaya. Nyaya is justice, dharma is not justice. Then now they're looking at you in a confused way and wondering, sir aap bahut confused kar rahe ho sir, because all my life I've gone to temples, main dharma dharma ki baat karta hu, main ghar ke bare mein sochta hu. हाँ लेकिन शब्द का अर्थ क्या है? Because if you don't get it, how do you write a script? I'll never forget that one of the characters was working as Ram. I went to the set to talk to him, to motivate them and all that. Show was not doing so well. And the guy looked at me and said, sir, ये राम का एक्टिंग क्या करूँ? वो हमेशा चेहरा एक जैसा होता है. वो स्माइल नहीं करता है, गुस्सा नहीं होता है, he is not upset. वो एक्टिंग क्या करूँ मैं? I tried to explain to him the idea of Ram, but he was like, this is too complicated. Because he wants a hero who goes through a transformation. He wants a hero like Skywalker, Luke Skywalker. He wants to be like the Hobbit. he wants to go through a transformation, which is the hero's journey of Lord of the Rings, which is like Harry Potter transforming himself. Ramayana is not about transformation. Fundamental. Because it is not a Greek story. Greek stories are about transformation. Biblical stories are about problem solving. Indian stories are neither about transformation or problem solving. When God comes down to earth, He is establishing dharma. What is dharma then? He is coming down as a teacher. He is coming down as a teacher to tell people what is dharma. And of course, the easiest way to discount dharma is to say it's very complicated. Everybody has a different point of view. Your point of view, my point of view. No, 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 no. The fundamentals are very clear from the Shatapatha Brahmana itself. Dharma means when humans don't behave as animals do. Humans are separate from animals. Prakriti, nature functions according to a set of rules. Nature functions based on a set of rules. All animals follow the law of the jungle, which is called Matsya Nyaya, where the big fish eat the small fish and it is okay. When the big eat the small, in the jungle it is okay. Matsya Nyaya, the big fish eats the small fish, it is okay. But in human society, when the big consume or exploit the small, it is adharma. It is wrong. Dharma, therefore, is when the strong help the weak. When the strong help the weak, that's the only one line meaning of dharma. So when Krishna is saying dharma sthapana yuge yuge, he is saying I'm enabling humans to become humans. 100 brothers are fighting 5 brothers. Who is stronger? 100. 100 brothers have 11 armies. 5 brothers have 7 armies. Do your math. Who is stronger? 100 brothers with 11 armies. You are stronger. You have to take care of the weaker, but you are fighting them as equals. Adharma. That's all it means. Nothing else. You're not a bad person. You are nobody's bad in the Ramayana Mahabharata. There is no talk of justice or injustice. It is just that to badappan dikha yaar. Ye raste ka Bombay ka, you go to a panwala shop, he will explain to you what badappan is. That is all. Avatarna ka matlab hai badappan dikhana. Main niche aata hoon taki tu upar uthe. Uddhar. When I come down, you go up. That is the meaning of avatarana. Ram is coming down as the prince of Ayodhya not to establish justice. If you wear the lens of justice and write it as novelists do nowadays, you don't get the Ramayana. That is not the Ramayana. Nyaya ke saath kuch lena dena hai hi nahi. Dharma ke saath badappan dikhao. And the complexity, because dharma is not easy. Hamesha dharma ke saath dharma sankat aayega. Dharma ke saath dharma sankat aayega. What is dharma sankat? You are hungry. Mujhe bhook laga hai. Mujhe bhook laga hai. Hungry. You go to the Raja and say, I want to eat something. King, I want to eat something. Very famous story from the Raghuvamsha. The very famous story from the Raghuvamsha. The king, there has been told to protect a cow. Okay, I will not use the word cow. It's very dangerous. Goat. The king has been told to take care of a goat. You get the idea, right? We don't want controversy. So, goat. The king has to take care of a goat. When a lion or a tiger appears and says, "Mere ko bakri khane ka hai. I want to eat the goat." The Raja says, "Maine nahi bakri nahi kha sakte, mera protection, I have to protect." So the tiger asks, तो फिर मैं खाऊंगा क्या, मेरे को भूख लगा है, तो हिरन को खाना। बकरी को बचाने के लिए हिरन मरेगा तो तू पाप कर रहे है पुण्य? आर यू डूइंग राइट? Are you doing the good thing or the bad thing? You're saving the goat, yes. But in exchange, you're saying the deer has to die. Somebody has to die, na? Nahi to tumko khana kaise milega? Who should die? Raja? Tumhara bakri ya jungle ka hiran? Bol. Kiski maut tere sar pe? That is called conflict. That is where the camera has to pan. That is where the music has to shift. Because there is no right answer. कोई तो जब तक बलि नहीं होगा तब तक भोग नहीं मिलेगा और भूख नहीं मिटेगी। किसी का तो बलि चढ़ना पड़ेगा। Somebody has to die. That is called धर्म संकट. राम has to do धर्म संकट. Should he listen to the gossip of the people or should he protect the innocent wife? What will you do? Your innocent family or WhatsApp messages? What does the public want? Public ki baat sunega? Ya ek bichari abala ki baat sunenge? Raja? Raja to public ki baat sunega yaar. Ye to sanatan hai. Nahi to he'll be voted out of power. This is the meaning of Sanatan Satya. The bitterness of life. This is forever. Ye kabhi nahi badlega. What decision do you take? It is not right and wrong. The paradigm of right and wrong is a European, American, Western construct. The moment a writer says right, wrong, justice, injustice, the moment he says this, I said, tere ko nahi likh sakte hai, tu Ramayana Mahabharata nahi likh sakta. And of course they lose their temper, they will kya malum hai, apne aap ko bahut smart samajhta hai. Theek hai, mat suna. Right. 10 crore mein khush rahe. 10 billion dollar kabhi nahi banayega. Because you're not true to yourself. You're telling a story which the West can tell better. They are masters at it. They know what justice means, right and wrong means. It's the Western paradigm. Why do I say this? When you read the Bible, God is a judge. Bhagwan Nyayadhish hai. Tumhara jo bhi kaam hota hai, it is divided into halal and haram. Is it right or wrong? Aur ek kayamat ka din hota hai. There's a judgment day on which you will be judged. This is the structure of a biblical story. This is how biblical stories are told. Puranon mein Bhagwan Nyayadhish nahi hote. God is not a judge. Vishnu is not a judge. Shiva is not a judge. Chitragupta is not a judge. Yamraj is not a judge. Chitragupta is a munim, accountant. When there is no judge, there is no judgment. Halal and haram does not mean paap and punya. It is a totally different concept. It's a categorical error. There is no kayamat. There is no concept of judgment day. You will never be judged. You will die, you will be reborn. You will die, you will be reborn. You will die, you will be reborn. You will die. Beej aur phal. Beej aur phal. Beej aur phal. Yahan pe right wrong kuch hai hi nahi. Tu jo karega uska phal milega tereko. Abhi achha phal ya bura phal? How do you know? How do you know? Somebody told me that life is about justice. I said that line, you know, it comes from the Old Testament. When you read the Bible, the Old Testament says, an eye for an eye. That is justice. An eye for an eye. So when anything happens in India, people say, humko bhi badla lene ka hai. Because it's full of violence and valor. Achha story banta hai usse. Main revenge lunga, mere baap ko mara hai. तेरा बाप चोर है, all that, no? Full of vengeance, pent up frustration. The great hero, Nayak, he goes, he transforms. Eye for an eye. Read the New Testament. Jesus says, not eye for an eye, turn the other cheek. So not vengeance, not retribution, but forgiveness. Kshama. Pyar, prem, kshama. Now what is greater, revenge or forgiveness? When you are writing a story, when you are writing the Ramayana, should it be about revenge or should it be about forgiveness? Revenge, forgiveness. But then both of these are biblical constructs. Ramayana is not the Bible. Mahabharata is not the Bible. Revenge kaha aaya, forgiveness kaha aaya? Shri Krishna, look at this, dono maya mein phase hue hain. Ye dono maya hai. Aise thodi na duniya chalta hai. Because you believe in rebirth. There is no concept of rebirth in the Bible. Karma phal ka matlab hi nahi hai. It is a different paradigm. दुनिया को देखने का एक अलग दृष्टिकोण है तो कहानी भी अलग होगी. I read a novel written on the Ramayana Mahabharata and I can say the writer has worn the hat of a lawyer and he writes great speeches. Ram is wrong, Sita is right, Hanuman is wrong, Ravan is right. Why are you being a lawyer? You are a novelist, a storyteller, not a lawyer. Who are you defending? Who is your judge? Karna was right, Arjuna was wrong, Krishna was wrong, Duryodhana was right. Are? Right, wrong. Great storytelling, but not Indian storytelling. Fantastic. Bestseller is TRP rating, paise milenge, itna. Utna nahi. Because you can never measure opportunity cost. Because wo Indian story nahi hai, yaar. Tu British story bol raha hai. इंडियन स्टोरी बोलना मुश्किल है. यहां पे माया कैसे समझाओगे, कर्म फल कैसे समझाओगे? सब माया है. पुनर्जन्म, राम का अवतरण, धर्म और धर्म संकट. धर्म इज नॉट एथिक्स. धर्म संकट इज नॉट एथिकल डिलेमा. दीज आर कॉम्प्लेक्स आइडियाज. कृष्णा धर्म संकट धर्म एस्टैब्लिश करते, धर्म स्थापना करते हैं. व्हाट डज ही गेट इन रिटर्न? व्हाट डज कृष्णा गेट इन रिटर्न? गांधारी का श्राप. तुम्हारे बच्चे, तुम्हारा पूरा वंश, यदुवंश, निर्वंश हो जाओगे तुम और कुत्ते की मौत मरोगे जंगल में. अ हंटर विल शूट यू डाउन लाइक एन एनिमल. प्रभु हो, पशु की मौत मरोगे. दैट्स अ फेमस धर्मवीर भारतीय डायलॉग इन अंधारी. प्रभु हो, पशु की मृत्यु मरोगे. यू कैन कर्स गॉड. यू कांट डू दैट इन एनी अदर कल्चर. इज इट राइट और रॉन्ग व्हाट गांधारी डिड? इट्स नीदर राइट नॉर रॉन्ग. इट इज जस्ट द रेज ऑफ अ मदर. बीज और फल. यू मे हैव एस्टैब्लिश धर्म, यू मे हैव किल्ड द कौरवास, बट दैट डज नॉट टेक अवे कर्म. धर्म और कर्म, very different concepts. When you read the Valmiki Ramayana, the first chapter begins with this beautiful episode where Valmiki is in the river bank. He sees two birds flying in the air. A hunter shoots one of the birds. The bird dies. The second, jo uska mate hota hai, wo roti roti hue, she's crying and crying and crying. And Valmiki is so touched by the motion, the emotion of that moment, that he curses the hunter. वो श्राप देता है, लेकिन श्राप कम्स आउट इन अ म्यूजिकल फॉर्म, इन अ पोएटिक फॉर्म. शोक से श्लोक का निर्माण होता है. फ्रॉम पेन कम्स पोएट्री. दैट इज वाइज आदि कवि. बट दिस इज द क्लू ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर. रामायण इज टॉकिंग अबाउट सेपरेशन ऑफ लवर्स बाय एन अनकॉल्ड फॉर फोर्स कॉल्ड द हंटर. हंटर इज द कर्मा. Or the sorrow of it, of being separated. Now read the Ramayana. Ramayana has nothing to do with war, it has to do with separation. Viraha, viraha, viraha. The tears of Mandodari when Ravan is killed. The tears of Tara when Vali is killed. The tears of Dashrath when his beloved son is going away to the forest. दिल टूट गया.
करुणारस, करुणारस, एंड दैट इज वाई द सेपरेशन ऑफ राम एंड सीता रिपीटेडली इन द रामायण. तुम कभी साथ में नहीं रहोगे. इधर कैकेयी's वर्ड्स और पब्लिक गॉसिप विल सेपरेट यू. सो रामायण इज नॉट वीर रस एट ऑल. इट इज नॉट अबाउट अ मैन होल्डिंग अ बो और वेयरिंग अ क्राउन. इट इज अबाउट सेपरेशन, विरह. वो विरह. It has nothing to do with right and wrong, justice. That structure is wrong. We don't get it. Indian storytelling, Natya Shastra, is about ras or bhav. Ras and bhav, sensory stimulation and emotional turmoil, which leads you towards divinity. And what is divinity in India? It is not a god who judges. I remember a school child asking me once, a young girl asked me, "Sir, what is God?" So I looked at her and said, "Wisdom." She looked at me, "Wisdom?" Because it was like, she was like, she was useless nonsense. She said, "Powerful nahi hai kya God? God has to be powerful, na? Tod phod kar sakta hai, haath aise karke shraap de sakta hai." For her, God was being powerful. For her, God was not being wise. Bhagwan is superhero, jo problem solve kar sakta hai. That is how she has been raised. God is not the wise one jo badappan dikhata hai and understands the complexity of life. That when you listen to the people of Ayodhya, Sita has to suffer. When you kill the Kauravas, you will have to deal with the shrap of Gandhari. Yes, for dharma sthapana, you have to kill the 100 Kauravas, but Bhima's son will also die, Arjun's son will also die, Draupadi's son will also die. Everybody will die. Ram will live in the palace, establish Ram Rajya, but his brother will leave him and die alone. His wife and children will be in the forest. He will live a lonely life. It's a very different story. Ramayana is not about problem solving. It is the life of Ram from birth to death. It's a biography. Mahabharata is not about winning a war. It is the story of the Pandavas from birth to death and the complexities of life. Most importantly, these are about dharma. And how do I know that dharma means taking care of the weak? Just go to the Vishnu Purana and say, what is the first avatar of Vishnu? And the first avatar of Vishnu is of a fish. Why fish? Why not a bird? And don't give me the Charles Darwin's theory of evolution. That's meant for really bad engineers for IIT. It basically is Matsya Nyaya, because the fish comes to Manu and says, save me from the big fish. मुझे बड़ी मछली से बचाओ, which is मत्स्य न्याय. And Manu lifts him up and puts him in a jar of water. That is the beginning of dharma. The strong shall take care of the weak. But then dharma sankat starts, because the fish gets bigger and bigger and bigger, so he needs more and bigger pots, resources. He needs more resources. He needs more and more resources. He puts the fish in a pond, then he puts it in a lake, then he puts it in a river, and finally he says, I can't take care of you anymore. And the fish says, I can take care of myself. Chhod do mereko. And then we are told a pralaya happens, and Manu's city, everything is being submerged underwater, and the big fish comes and saves Manu. The way you helped the small fish when it was weak, when the small fish becomes big, it will come and help you in times of trouble. इसे कर्म कहते हैं. Now please watch all the Dashavatar serials which are on television and show me one of them which explains this concepts with fantastic special effects. None of them. None of them. Because none of them believe in the scriptures. They just want special effects. They think Lord of the Rings is special effects. Lord of the Rings is not special effects. It's based on Viking mythology, it's based on the Greek myths. The structure is fantastic. The design, the costumes are appropriate because you have created a Scandinavian worldview, but superimposed on it a Greek narrative structure. it either intuitively, because they don't know anything else. When I talk to script writers from America, they listen because they've never heard anything like this. We have We're too busy wanting to be successful than preparing for success. And it's something that breaks my heart, because for the last 5 years I've been working with writers and production houses, and it's, let me be honest, I make a lot of money. So Lakshmi ne mujhe bahut sukh diya hai, lekin Saraswati ne sukh nahi diya. Because you keep seeing this block, this block, this block, because ultimately the way had to be, hum logo nyay chahiye, justice chahiye. Never forget this arrogant producer telling me, ultimately, sir, audience ko kya chahiye? Kuch bloodshed or revenge drama. Mere liye Mahabharat revenge drama hai, jo kuch bolo kuch farak nahi padta. And I'm like, well, he made a few crores. He didn't make the $1 billion. Marvel, Disney, Netflix, talk in billions and billions of dollars. We don't. Hamari aukaat wahan tak nahi pahunchi. Not because we are not capable. We are brilliant. But we do not believe in the brilliance of our scriptures. We believe stories have to have revenge or forgiveness. Eye for an eye or turn the other cheek. There are other options. Ramayana and Mahabharata is neither about that, neither about forgiveness nor about justice. It is about the flow of life and the drama of life. Ravan is the great scholar who knows the Vedas but is not able to understand consent. Itna gyan ho ke bhi ek choti cheez nahi samajh mein paata ki a woman is not interested in you. He is like most Bollywood lovers. Nahi bola na, ja bhi. Nahi. Never take no for an answer. Have you heard this ridiculous line? It doesn't apply in human relationships. It only applies in stupid corporate workshops. Consent samajh mein nahi aata hai. I remember this feminist writer telling me, I think Ravan has been treated rather badly by Indian people. I think there's something nice. I said, yes. And she was like a really well-known feminist author. And I couldn't believe I was hearing this. I said, yeah, that's true. I mean, consent doesn't matter, does it? And she realized she had made a big mistake and she had to change the topic rapidly. This consent, bhaiya, usko tere ghar mein nahi rehne ka hai, chhod. Nahi, Ravan na Vedacharya hai. Are, sun to. She is saying she's not interested in you. Can't you get it with your 10 heads? And that is, ladies and gentlemen, the problem with the telling the story, because it's the story of a superly intelligent, capable man who can't understand basic things. That is the tragedy of the Ramayana. Mandodari is watching him and saying, tu itna gadha hai. You are letting your brother die, Kumbhakarna dies. You are letting your son die, Meghanad dies. Your kingdom is getting burnt. And you are not letting Sita go. What Vedas do you know? Please tell me which Veda have you read? Ye matsya nyay hai ki dharma hai? Ye matsya nyay hai. Tu bada, wo choti hai. Usko nahi chahiye tera pyar. Or whatever you call it. But you know, modern millennials say, Ravan is so cool. 10 heads, 20 hands, private jet, aur kya chahiye? Yeah, consent. That is why Indian men don't get it. Consent. And that is why Ramayana cannot be written. That is why people struggle to write the Ramayana. When Ramanand Sagar's Ramayana was successful, please remember, he used Tulsi Ramayana's Doha in every background score. It was Tulsi Das who was successful, not a Bollywood writer. have the humility to say, because har jo bhi, the beginning, everything in the Sagar Ramayana is Tulsidas. And he has surrendered. Sagar had the humility. And maybe it is an older generation. Yeah, Tulsidas ke samne, don't try to outdo him. Kuch to humility rakho shastron ke upar. Tulsidas Gosai ji hai, unhe samajh mein aata hai kya likhna hai. And the serial stopped in India. Everybody watched the serial because it came with bhav. It was redone. It didn't work because nobody believed it. Ek bhav hota hai, ek ras hota hai. Ramayana, Mahabharat, complex storytelling. Structure, architecture, very different. It is not the hero myth. There is no full stop. There is only comma. There is no full stop. There is phal or beech, phal or beech, phal or beech. These are complex ideas. They are beautiful ideas. They are beautiful ideas. Ras bhara. Ras bhara. Isliye ras. Isliye actor ko hum kya bolte hain? Patra hai. A character is called a patra. Patra means a vessel. What does the vessel contain? Ras. Jiska aap swaad dete ho. The theater, the stage, the screen is like a meal. Jisme tum bhog chadhate ho. Kuch meetha hota hai, kuch khatta hota hai. Kuch pakwan hota hai, kuch raw hota hai. Salad jaisa hota hai, kabhi kabhi keto diet hota hai. Lekin bhog hai ye. You have to eat it. In order to eat food, it must look good. It must smell good. That's called advertising. When you eat it, it has to taste good. So when you're watching it, you'll say, paisa vasool. As it goes into the stomach, you feel a joy as you're leaving the restaurant. That joy, they will tell others also, ja ke kha, bahut achha hai. That is called referral, double ticket. You want to eat again and again, that's called repeat order. That's how films are successful. When you see the film again and again and tell others to see the film. Of course, 3 days later, if you get diarrhea, you will never go back to such films again. Headache, nausea, vomiting. Food, bhog hai. Natya Shastra does not look at stories as characters and plots. It only says, kya bhav, kya ras, patra, kya bhav la raha hai, kya ras la raha hai. That's all it matters. Shuruaat mein kya hota hai, last mein kya hota hai. Last mein gulab jamun milega ki nahi milega. या तुम्हारा पान का बिड़ा होगा जिसको खाके मैं घर जाके मेरे प्रियतम के साथ बिताऊंगा रात. That is Natyashastra. And that is what I wish all of you create the brilliance of India so that the world comes to you. You don't beg the world to come to you. Thank you.